Hi students, now let's study today new topic, that is regulation of gene. In this note, I will just explain you how gene expressions are controlled, how gene expressions are controlled in eukaryotes and in prokaryotes. This is the basic thing you should know. See, here we have studied in eukaryotes, I have taught you protein synthesis. In protein synthesis, I have taught you protein synthesis is completed in two steps, that is transcription and translation. See, everywhere, all the steps are controlled by gene expression. Okay, here transcription level, where from DNA, mRNA is synthesized, it is also controlled by gene. Second is transport of mRNA, when mRNA is synthesized and when it gets transported from nucleus to cytoplasm, this process is also controlled by gene. Last level, that is translational level, where from mRNA protein is synthesized, and there also it is important, and especially in the processing level where the splicing, capping and telling takes place, there also gene plays important role. In short, every step in eukaryotes, at every stage gene expression is playing important role. Now see, here in prokaryotes also genes are controlling, gene expression is everywhere controlled. I'll give you one example. See, we'll consider in prokaryote, we'll consider one bacteria, that is E. coli bacteria. If glucose is needed by this bacteria, so what happens? This lactose, and if lactose is present in the surrounding, okay, we are studying how genes are controlling their expression. What happens, or you can say how genes are helping everywhere. See what happens, we'll consider one example, that is E. coli bacteria. If glucose is needed by this bacteria and lactose is available in the surrounding, what happens? The gene releases one enzyme called as beta-galactosidase. This beta-galactosidase breaks this lactose into glucose and galactose, and hence in this way glucose gets available to the bacteria. Means here also genes are playing very important role. Next, if we consider another example, if glucose is not needed by the E. coli bacteria is having sufficient amount of glucose, then what happens? Then enzyme beta-galactosidase is not required. Actually, why it is not required? Because what is its function? To break down the lactose and to give rise to glucose and galactose. But glucose is not at all required by E. coli. Then what happens? This gene functions are controlled as per the requirement. These genes will not secrete beta-galactosidase. This I'll explain you with the help of one example. See, if we had lot of sweets, okay, then what happens? In our blood, sugar level will increase. Okay, then what happens? Our body will secrete, genes of our body or DNA will secrete one enzyme called as insulin. That insulin will control the blood sugar level, or the level of sugar in the blood. It is maintained. Okay, so what is happening here? When we are consuming sugar, excess amount of sugar, naturally insulin is secreted by the gene and it controls the level. But if we have not consumed sugar, okay, this insulin will not be secreted, because there is no need of maintaining the sugar level in the blood. Okay, so in this way, genes are only responsible for controlling each and every action taking place inside the cell. Okay, now let's start with new topic, that is lac operon. Very interesting and very important topic. See, lac operon occurs in prokaryotes only. This lac operon is explained by two scientists, Jacob and Monod, in the year 1961. Okay, now with the help of this lecoperonno, these scientists have explained how gene expression is depended on the switch on and switch off mode of operator. This I'll explain you properly. Okay, but at present you have to keep in mind lecoperon occurs in prokaryotes, and this lecoperon is very nicely explained by two scientists, Jacob and Monad. In this they have explained about the gene expression. Okay, now first of all you should know the components of lecoperon. Lecoperon consists of 5 components: regulatory gene, promoter gene, operator gene, structural gene and inducer. Actually in lecoperon, no, these 4 are only the important constituent. Inducer is not the component of lecoperon, but it is playing important role in lecoperon process, no, that's why we are including it here. So lecoperon consists of 5 components: RPOSI. R for regulatory gene, promoter gene, operator gene, structural gene and inducer gene. Now, see, first of all, we will see the site. See, this is the regulatory gene, first gene, which is our first gene, R. Second gene is, site is this promoter here, the promoter genes are present. Third one is operator, here operator genes are present. Fourth one is structural gene. So see, these are the 4 important component of lecoperon, but we are considering this inducer also because it is playing very important role. So these are the sites. Then first we'll study about regulatory gene. See where this regulator gene is present. This is the site, this green color band here, this part is called as, this is the part of regulator gene. Regulatory gene controls the operator site. See where is operator site? This is the operator site. So regulator gene, from here only it controls the operator site. Regulator gene produces protein called as repressor protein, which binds the operator site and stop the process. Means, see what happening, how this regulatory gene is controlling the operator site. What happens, this regulatory gene produces repressor protein, and this repressor protein binds to the operator site and stop the process of lecoperon. Okay, next is promoter gene. See, promoter gene, where it present, it is present, it precedes. Precedes means it present before the operator site. Can you see this? Promoter gene is present here. Where it is present just before the regulatory gene. What is its function? It provides the binding site of RNA and helps in the process of transcription. Promoter, you know, every time this promoter helps in the binding of RNA polymerase. Promoter means starting. RNA polymerase comes and attaches to this site only. Then, when the operator gene is turned on, the enzyme moves over the operator gene and transcription of structural gene starts. Means what happens? See, now this promoter site is there. To this promoter site, RNA polymerase get attached. Okay, and when this operator site, or when this blocked, when this repressor protein get moves, no, or when it get removed, this RNA polymerase can proceed forward. Okay, this I'll explain you later on with the help of diagram also. Next one is operator gene. Where this operator gene is present, this blue color band, this is nothing but operator gene. It controls the functioning of structural gene. What the operator means, it is controlling all the functions of the structural gene. How it is controlling, I'll explain you just now. Then structural gene. Last one is structural gene. See here, structural gene is given here 1, 2 and 3. Actually here it is Z gene. See here it is Z. this is Y gene and this is A gene. See here, 1 means Z gene, 2 means Y gene, and 3 means A gene. 3 different types of genes are present. What is their function? See, genes means they are producing one enzyme. Z gene is responsible for producing beta galactosidase. Y gene produces enzyme permease and A gene produces enzyme transacetylase. Okay, this Z gene produces beta galactosidase. This Y gene produces enzyme permease and this last gene, that is A gene, produces enzyme transacetylase. So here we have completed structural gene. Now last point, that is inducer. Inducer is nothing but it is allo lactose. It is a chemical. It is just like lactose only. Okay, in the cytoplasm, what is its function? What is the function of inducer? It inactivates the repressor protein. See here, in the diagram I'll show you, this is inducer. This repressor, no, this inducer binds to the repressor and this repressor protein get inactivated. So what is the function of inducer? Inducer is nothing but it is allolactose. It just bind to this repressor protein and the repressor protein gets inactivated. Okay, then next point we are going to study, I'll just explain you now how the lac operon takes place. We have to consider one condition: if lactose is not present in the surrounding, or you can say if glucose is not required by the cell, so lactose is not present. We will study two conditions: if lactose is present and if lactose is absent. See, if lactose is absent, what happens? See, these are the site. This is I means this is regulatory site. This is promoter site. Actually, this is called as operon. Huh? Operon means the group of gene. Okay, it is a segment of DNA which is containing certain genes. See, this site is called as regulatory gene. Here some genes are present, this site is called as regulatory site or I site. This site is called as promoter site. This region is called as operator region. Here there is presence of or band of three type of gene: Z gene, Y gene, A gene. Z gene is responsible for producing beta galactosidase. Y gene is responsible for producing lactose permease or permease enzyme, and A gene is responsible for producing transacetylase. Okay, now see what happens if there is no lactose in the surrounding. What happens if lactose is not present? Means what? This regulatory gene produces mRNA with the help of transcription process. This regulatory gene produces mRNA. From this mRNA, naturally, you know, translation takes place and protein is synthesized. This protein is called as repressor protein. See, why this step is taking place? Here there is absence of lactose. No lactose is there. So beta galactose, there is no need of secretion of beta galactosidase. So how this process can be stopped? See, no lactose means no work of beta galactosidase. What happens here if there is no need? Now we have to stop the secretion of beta galactosidase. So what happens? This I gene, regulatory gene, produces mRNA by the process called transcription. This mRNA by the process of translation produces one protein. This protein is called as repressor protein. Repressor protein go here or towards the operator site and it blocks the operator site. Okay. Regulatory gene produces mRNA. mRNA produces repressor protein. Repressor protein blocks the operator site. Then what happens? You know, towards the protein promoter site, DNA polymerase get attached. Now this polymerase, what is the function of this polymerase? This polymerase, when it will proceed, no, when it has to grow, go like this, okay? But what happens? Here the road or the path of the polymerase is blocked. by the repressor protein. So there is no option for this polymerase to move forward, and as it is not moving forward, beta galactosidase is not secreted. Then what happens? Now here, see how it is blocked. It is not allowing the polymerase to enter through it. This condition, this pathway is blocked by the repressor protein. This is the first condition when lactose is absent. Now what happens if this lactose is needed? Second point, when glucose, this cell need glucose, then what happens? Now there is the point there. You have to just imagine this way is blocked by the repressor protein. Then what happens if lactose is present in the cell, means there should be the degradation of lactose. For that, one enzyme is required, that is beta galactosidase. So what happens here? Here the cell, few part of lactose get converted into allolactose. Few part of this lactose get converted into allolactose. This allolactose, no, it binds. Now see, this inhibitor protein, or you can say repressor protein, is present here. It block the operator site. Now what this allolactose do, this is the, what is the function of allolactose? This allolactose binds to the operators, binds to the repressor protein. This repressor protein is very much fond of this allolactose, and as soon as there is secretion of allolactose, this allolactose binds to the repressor site. Okay, and as it binds to the repressor site, what happens? This path get open. This, what is the function of allolactose? Allolactose binds to the repressor protein, and the repressor protein gets deactivated, means it leaves the operator site, and this polymerase can easily now pass through it. Just see. Now this polymerase can easily pass, you know, from here it is passing through this enzyme, that is Z enzyme. As soon as it passes through the Z enzyme, what happens? Beta galactosidase is produced. Okay, this polymerase has left. Now these three enzymes get secreted. Now beta galactosidase, what this enzyme is doing? This beta galactosidase breaks the lactose into glucose and galactosidase. This permease allows continuously the entry of lactose, and this transacetylase provides, or it transfers the acetyl group towards the beta galactosidase. In another way, it is helping beta galactosidase in breaking down of lactose. So here I have taught you about lacoperon. See, again I'll repeat this. Lacoperon, this is called as lacoperon. Operon means the group of gene, cluster of gene. Many genes are present over here. You see, regulatory gene is present, promoter gene is present, operator gene is present, structural genes are present, and inducers are also present. What happens here? We have studied two conditions. If glucose is not required by the cell, what happens? This regulatory gene produces mRNA. From the mRNA, repressor protein is present. Repressor protein goes and block the operator site, and hence this RNA polymerase do not get the wave. This RNA polymerase, which is attached to the promoter site, do not get passage. It do not get transferred because of this blockage. No, it was unable to transfer the structural gene, and there is no synthesis of beta galactosidase. Now second condition is there, on mode. If the cell requires glucose and there is a presence of lactose, then what happens? This repressor protein, no, which is here, it is blocking the operator site. What happens? As soon as the lactose is, or the glucose is required by the cell, little amount of allolactose is produced. Allolactose is nothing but it is inducer. Little amount of lactose get converted into allolactose, and it is acting as an inducer. What it do? It binds with the repressor protein here. It goes here towards the repressor protein, and as soon as the inducer binds the repressor protein gets inactivated, means it gets removed from this site, and RNA polymerase proceeds through the structural gene. As soon as it proceeds, what happens? Different enzymes are formed. First enzyme is formed is beta galactosidase, which helps in the degradation of lactose into glucose. Simultaneously, when it is passing, mRNA is synthesized, and from mRNA new protein is synthesized. So here we have completed lacoperon. Here we have shown how everything is controlled by the gene. So we have completed lacoperon.